The Hoyer I'm getting a bit sick of. I've had that several years now, and it's attempted one bloom and the bloom blasted, and it's never done anything since other than produce big long vining stems. You know, things in this greenhouse, obviously it's an enclosed environment and there is limited space, and I don't want to carry anything that doesn't really provide me with what I want. I quite like the look of that thing, but I would really love some of the blooms because they are apparently very fragrant. Begonia listarda, looking great. I've kind of twisted it off to one side there to hold it up because it kept popping over because it's getting a bit top heavy now. This one is Begonia silver lace, which looks really nice in the sunshine. It's really dull today, so you're not getting the best of that. That looks excellent when the sun's on it. They're the leaf cuttings of all the different Sepalias that I've got. I mean, they were in like little plastic bags, but I think it's 80-odd% humidity in here anyway, so they should be okay now. They were in the plastic bags for several weeks, but yeah, I can't see any new growth on them yet. I think they come as little plantlets down at the bottom. I'm sure somebody will jump on and tell me that. I've not looked it up. Begonia nigricans, something or other, which I forget. Maize IF nigricans. It's looking very nice. These leaves are a lot darker. I don't know, maybe the heat, maybe it's the humidity, I don't know, but they are changing. They were a lot darker and velvety, a lot more velvety than they're looking at the moment. That's the other Calaria, so I'm expecting that to bloom soon. That got the same treatment, but for some reason it's just not grown at the same speed. I did repot this Miltonia spectabilis, and I repotted this a couple of years ago. In fact, it was November 2019, so it was one of the first videos I made. And looking back at it, I mean, I was very open about it. I had absolutely no idea what I was doing. And I just, as I always do anyway, I just tell people where I'm up to with these things. I'm under no illusions. I'm not an expert at growing orchids. I just tell people where I'm up to, what I know, and they can take that, you know, however they like. And I put it in coconut huts. My new favourite media for this particular environment, for my environment. I should get a t-shirt. I'm going to get a t-shirt made that just says, for my environment. But it's growing much better since I put it in here. I had it in pots, and what I had in the pots was bark and a mixture of other things. And it had put absolutely zero roots down. And that just tells you, obviously, that that was the wrong media for it in my environment. Remember the t-shirt? In my environment. And since I've moved it over to this already, there's tons more growth on it. And I'm hoping I get some blooms on it because the blooms for that thing were absolutely gorgeous. Love them. Much like this Bulbophyllum Elizabeth Ann Buckleberry has done better since I put it into one of these baskets. But obviously that one isn't in the coconut husk, that one is in moss. But I believe they need to be a lot more damp than I was keeping it. So hopefully that will do something. So let's just move on and see what else we have to discuss. Oh, somebody was, I think it was the Here But Not guy actually, was talking about vandas and how they need loads and loads of light. So many hours of sunshine every day, not getting it here. But yeah, I see people growing them in the UK quite successfully. I mean, I've got the grow light there, but I don't know, for whatever reason, it hasn't done anything, not yet anyway. I think I'm not feeding it enough. Oh my goodness, what is he up to? Look at this. Fudge, that can't be good for you, mister. Look, oh dear me. Hey, stop it. He thinks he's flossing his teeth. And what on earth do you call that? That was not how I left it. Hey, stop it, Fudge. Yeah, I know you want to eat. I know you want to eat the banana, but it's the banana fruit we eat, not the bark. See, butter wouldn't melt. See, look at everybody. Say hello. Look at the people. Fudgy. Fudge. Fudge. Look this way. Fudge. Hey. Hello. Hello. I know what you want. That. Oh, I missed. I missed the door. How can you miss the door? Come here. Give me the ball. Give me the ball. Fudge. Give me the ball. Give me the ball. Right. Oh, missed it again. I'm not left-handed, you see. Now, if it had been my right hand, it'd have gone straight through the gap. Give me the ball. What's... Ew, disgusting. Yuck. The lovely, but the disgusting. Right, here we go. Cannot possibly miss. Oh. For some reason, it didn't go through. Right, okay. Well, let's carry on with what we're supposed to be doing. This isn't a dog channel. No, he's gone, thankfully. Right, okay. Now, you've seen it tons of times, but look at it. Look at how fantastic that looks. And it is going to bloom. I can't remember. I put a picture up. I can't remember what the blooms are like on these things. I don't think they're anything wonderful. But it's never done this. It took 4 years to do this. And there's no way. Can you imagine trying to repot that? There's no way you could repot. Well, I've never seen it done anyway. I wouldn't like to attempt it. Fortunately, they like really poor soil, so it's not going to suffer much from the poor soil. So where are we? What else have we got? Now, look at this. This is new. So this is one of my species pelargoniums. So this is Pelargonium trifidum. So does it look like, remember The Day of the Triffids? Good book, that. Good book. Isn't that cute? I really like that. I think that's... I'm kind of developing a taste for the subtle. And I think, okay, yeah, I still like big blousy things, but that is lovely. Fudge! Stop, stop, stop! Fudge! No. 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 Okay, Trifidum. So, where are we? What else can we talk about? Looking good still, Dendrobium cuthbertsonii. Got to keep my eye out for the watering to make sure that I keep on top of it. And using my newfound knowledge on, you cannot overwater. All you can do is provide the wrong media. So if you think you're giving them too much water and it's staying wet, then that's probably because you've got the wrong media. But with these, of course, they need certain amount anyway, a certain amount of moisture. So I think I've got it right. I'll only know if I've got it right if I can get it through another winter. That's the key. Now, have a look at this. So this is a Tradescantia. This is one of the green cuttings that I took from Tradescantia tricolor minima. So that is tricolor minima. But however I show this, when I show it on Instagram, on video, it never comes out as nice as it looks in real life. And I doubt it even shows up properly on the camera. And then in the corner you've got the maiden's blush, which seems to be going more white than cream at the moment, and it's much bigger than some of the other maiden's blush goes. So that's that. We've got the Nanook lilac, which is looking very lilac, so prone to like the brown tips and leaf spot. I can't remember if I've shown this or not. So this is a species, so this is Brassia or Ada or Antiarca, I think, or Antiarca variety punctata. Okay, so that bloomed last year for me, blooming again, very nice, like that. And I know lots of people have got these now, so, and I'm not saying I started everybody off, I started the trend. So this Begonia curly fireflush, it is going to bloom. And seeing as how successful these other begonias were at blooming, they were much nicer than I anticipated them to be. I wonder if that's going to be as nice. I don't know. Fudge! Hey! Fudge! Stop it! Dear, oh dear. It's like having a three-year-old. Right, where were we? I've had to ban the fluffy one because he is intent on eating my banana, and I don't really want that to cause him any problems. Okay, so we have our pinguiculas here. That one's not looking too happy. Don't know why. That one's completely vanished. These two are very nice. If I get any more of these, I'm going to make sure I get the bigger, I think it's the Mexican varieties, because these smaller ones, for whatever reason, that I'm not really aware of, don't seem to be doing that well for me. These streps are beginning to come into proper growth and bloomage now, which will be nice. I'm ready for it. That's looking absolutely brilliant at the moment. Just make sure I keep pinching out those fully green ones. It's surprising how quickly they reappear. I don't particularly seem to be very good at growing Psilogyne cristata. I don't know whether I'm just not watering it enough, but it never looks great. Everybody else seems to grow them really, really easily. So these are the cuttings. Something's had a go at that. These are the cuttings from Tradescantia tricolor minima. That one's going to bloom. And they look gorgeous, don't they? Like those. So my Tradescantia salamontana, again, struggled through the winter, had a few rotting issues, but it seems to be okay now, so hopefully that's all right. We're okay with that. My Pteris aurantiaca, sorry, Pteris quadricolor. I don't know why I keep wanting to call that Pteris aurantiaca. Quadricolor. That one has got its bronze leaves, bronze fronds on it now, so that's looking good. My unifoliate there, that's Streptocarpus dunii. I'm hoping to get something on that soon. I have seen one of these Streptocarpus, the unifoliate ones, actually. That's quite floppy. I think that needs a water. I have seen one of those that these leaves go 3 or 4 feet long, and I think they're actually selling them at the moment at Dibley's. So I'm thinking, I really want it, but where am I going to put it? That's the issue. So, oh, that's going to bloom. I don't think I've had a bloom on my Cephalotus before. And this is the first year it's not actually sent up any new leaves. It just seems to be sending pictures. And the divisions that I took are also doing pretty well. You can see I do have the occasional problem with a little bit of this mouldy stuff, this white stuff on it. It's not sooty mould, is it? What is it? Mildew, powdery mildew. I'm not sure what's causing that on it. I know I've given it a spray with a fungicide in the past, and that seems to be okay. So my Brugmansia is in full leaf now. So far, fudge is still alive, thankfully. I'm very vigilant at picking any leaves up. That's going to bloom soon, so you just missed that. I should call this video the just missed the best bits. So this Fuchsioides, getting loads more blooms on it now. It's getting very tall. Now, this was the, what do you call it? Dendrobium Victoria Regina. And when the guy sent it to me, can't remember his name, Marius, something like that. That was like a green root on it. And I've sprayed it religiously every day, and the green has gone. So whether, and obviously the blooms have fallen off, the blooms lasted ages. Whether I'm doing the right thing with that, I'm not sure. Answers, please, in the comments.